Hi, this is Kevin with iHost Networks, and in this video I'll be going over the Edit Page section in your store. So on this page, you'll see your store here in the middle. It looks a little bit different than the preview does. You'll see it has a bunch of rectangles here at the top and also at the bottom, and these are spots where you can add widgets. And the widgets show up on the left-hand side, and we'll be covering these in just a second. And you can add these to the page by pretty much just dragging and dropping them into that rectangle. And you can do this for any page that you're on. So if I wanted to customize my apparel page, I just need to click on that tab and then go ahead and just drag and drop the widgets into that part of the page. And to get back to the home page of your store, you just need to press your store banner here at the top and it will take you back to the home page. Alright, you can also customize the login and checkout pages by using the drop-down menu in the upper right-hand corner, and it gives you some more options to go to. And one other thing to mention, you can press the Edit Banner text above your store banner, and this will launch the banner maker where you can create your own banner. So if you've already have your image uploaded, you don't need to click on that. Alright, well that takes care of a brief overview. Let's go over the widgets so we can find out what they do. On the left-hand side, you'll see two columns of widgets. Starting in the top left, there is a content block widget. This will allow you to add text, images, links, video onto the page, and this is generally what you'd use for most of your content. To the right of that is an HTML rotator. This is very similar to a content block, except it's generally used for HTML code. This can also be considered a rotating content block. Down below, there is a category list. This will show you a complete category structure of your store. Next to this is a product rotator. When you add this onto the page, you can select certain products, so each time the page is refreshed, it will show you a new product. A category rotator is pretty much like a product rotator, except it rotates categories instead of products. A featured product is like a product rotator, except it will always show you the exact same products. Below this is the option for a mailing list, so your customers can enter their email address in a field and stay in touch with you. And then there is a search widget, so your customers can type in what they're looking for. And at the bottom, there is a category grid widget, and this will allow you to display certain categories either in column or grid view. Now that we covered the widgets, let's go over adding a widget to the page. So for this example, I would like to add some text at the top of the page. So to do this, I need to use a content block. So what I need to do is on the left-hand side, put my mouse over the content block widget, hold down my left mouse button, and then go ahead and drag it to the part of the page I would like to add it. And you'll see how it highlights the rectangle in orange. This lets me know where it will be added, so I just need to let go of my mouse button and it will go ahead and add it there. And if I don't like where it was added, I can use the move icon here in the top corner and go ahead and position it to the part of the page where I'd like to move it to. So I'll go ahead and move it to my other content here and just let go. Alright, so whenever I add a module onto the page, it's disabled by default, which means that it's visible only to the administrator. So to make it visible to the customers, we'll need to go ahead and turn this module on. So to do this, you'll need to click on the little power icon here, and this will enable it, so I'll go ahead and click on that, and then it turns it green, so we know that it's active. And if I want to delete this module, I just need to press the red X button here, and it will go ahead and delete that. But for right now, let's go ahead and edit this module. So we just need to press the edit text here, and this will allow us to configure the module. All right, so to add our content, we just need to go over here and change the default text that shows up. So we go ahead and remove that. And I'm gonna type in something that says, thank you for visiting. Keep it simple. And then you can also adjust the size, fonts, the color using the menu tools here at the top. Some menu tools that I do want to point out, you can select some text and press the insert link here, so that way you can link to another website or you can link to a file that you've uploaded. I'll go ahead and unselect that. Then there's options here for insert an image, so you can add an image like below your text. There is an insert, actually another insert image. There's an insert embedded media option, so you can upload like maybe like a movie or something that you have saved on your computer. And above this, there is an option here for insert HTML code. So if you want to embed like a YouTube video, you just need to get the HTML code and then basically paste it into the window. This will also allow you to add other HTML code as well. And at the top of this module, it has an option for a title. So you can give your module a title. It will have a little, its own little bar with that name on it. If you don't, you can leave it blank and it won't have that title. And then below that, there is a spot here for a container. This changes the look of the container. So right now there is an options for article container, default container, no container, and also vmenu container. So I usually use the default container for what I do. All right, so once you made your change, go ahead and scroll down and then go ahead and press the Save Changes button. And that's really all there is to it. So go ahead and continue to set up your store, and thanks for watching.